We are tracking an active afternoon of weather across southern Colorado. Let's start off with a look from our neighborhood weather network camera in Woodland Park, and you can see the dark clouds have rolled in once again. And if you look just to the right of where that cluster of trees are, you can see some of the rain coming down, and this is associated with a new thunderstorm that we're going to tell you about. Storm Tracker 13 Live HD Doppler radar is showing it just off to the north and west of Woodland Park. It is traveling toward the east, so it is going to bring some rain here shortly to the Woodland Park area. You can also see those lightning bolts indicating that this storm is producing some thunder and lightning this afternoon. So as it travels overhead, you'll not only see it, you'll likely hear it too. It should pass just to the north of the Waldo Canyon burn scar, but we are starting to see a bit more in the way of storms popping up around the Pikes Peak region. So we will have to monitor the burn scars very, very closely as we head through the evening hours. Storms that develop today will be capable of producing heavy rain. So all we need is one to move over those scars to produce some flash flooding concerns. You'll notice that the strongest storms, though, really off to the east. This is where we have the most water to work with. So the strongest storms right now off to the north of the I-70 corridor, that area of blue, that is a severe thunderstorm watch that will stay in effect until 10 o'clock tonight, because we are expecting the storms in this area to maintain their strength as we head into the first part of the night tonight. So let's track that using SkyCast. Here's a look at the storms outside right now as we head into the next couple of hours. The majority of the activity is going to slide off toward the east. At 6 o'clock, we'll still have that strong band of storms across the eastern plains, but you'll notice that SkyCast is also keeping a few storms around the Colorado Springs and Pueblo area through the evening hours. Into the first part of the night tonight, we may have a few lingering storms up along the Palmer Divide, but as we head toward midnight, everything is going to come to an end. We'll have the clouds that will stick around through the night tonight into early tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning, we'll likely start off the day with some fog, but while you're sleeping tonight, colder air is going to filter into the state. You'll feel it tomorrow. These are a look at your high temperatures. We're only getting into the 60s and 70s tomorrow afternoon, so there is going to be a bit of a chill in the air. And these are our high temperatures. So tomorrow afternoon, when those thunderstorms get rolling again, you can expect the temperature to drop even further through the afternoon and into the evening. So we'll start off SkyCast through lunchtime. We will have some quiet conditions, but then around 2 o'clock is when we are expecting those storms to pop up over the mountains first, gradually sliding toward the east as we head into the late afternoon. The areas of yellow show that the storms tomorrow will be capable of producing heavy rain again. The strongest storms should really stick across the plains, though, before, just like tonight, everything should come to an end as we approach midnight tomorrow night. Coming at your 7-day forecast, today, tomorrow, really the crummiest days of the week. We are going to dry out as we head into Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Sunday right now looks to be the cooler of the two weekend days. We'll increase the clouds through Sunday afternoon, and then we warm right back into the 80s. Monday, Tuesday of next week, Wednesday, we'll drop it back into the 70s, though. Pueblo tomorrow, 76 degrees is all we'll see. We'll have that 20% chance for storms, and again, tomorrow morning, there may be some areas of low clouds, patchy fog that could slow you down, so we'll have all the latest on that, starting with Good Morning Colorado at 4:30. 92 degrees on Friday. We'll have 90s on Saturday, and then 80s are back Sunday into Monday. 90s return, though, Tuesday. And in Canyon City tomorrow, we will have that chance for storms during the afternoon. 75 degrees tomorrow, 90s though on Friday. We'll spend the weekend in the 80s. We'll keep the 80s around through Monday before warming into the 90s on Tuesday. And in Teller County, 63 degrees tomorrow with that 30% chance for storms. Could see some decent rain with the storms that do develop. So again, the burn scars are going to be an issue tomorrow afternoon. 74 degrees on Friday, 70 Saturday, then Sunday. We'll drop it back into the 60s. Could have a couple windy days here as we head into the end of the work week, into the weekend. But today, tomorrow, the stormiest days of the next 7 days, and then we start to get a bit drier.
All right.
You were saying it. Compared to last year, how interesting it is. It's not nearly as hot and dry as it was 1 year ago when the Black Forest fire in Whale Gorge started.
Yeah, and unfortunately, you know, flooding is a concern now, but man, I would take that concern over the massive drought that we were tracking for the past several years.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's definitely nice to see the rain out there today.
It is nice. Mm-hmm. And all I can keep thinking about is the weekend forecast. I didn't hear anything you just said. But I saw
coming.
That weekend forecast.
Yep. That's all that matters. I should just show Saturday, Sunday forecast. Forget everything else.
Thanks so much, Rachael.
Well, we showed you this earlier this week, a new Miss USA.